What is Fanna and what are its types? There is a question from someone. I am familiar with the terms Fanafil al-Sheikh, Fanafil Rasul, Fanafil Allah, but do you think that before any of these stages, or at least before one progresses to Fanafil Sheikh, Fanafil Nafs, diving deep into the ego is imperative? Without knowing one's nafs, a seeker cannot progress to the second stage. Is this what is meant by the hadith, "Fa man arfa nafsahu, fa kad arfa rabbahu"? First of all, I will go into Fana and explain through various examples what is meant by Fana. In Sufi terminology, Fana is a word from Sufi terminology. Although similar experiences do happen in other paths, but Fana is a term used by Sufi terminology, and it is widely used in others as well. Fana means extinction, dissolution, absorption. It means to annihilate the self. It means to annihilate the self while remaining physically alive. Now this can be understood. You want to make a sugar syrup. You take water, which is tasteless. You add a sugar syrup. For the people who are familiar with the concentrated sugar syrup, maybe it is ruapsa, or it is mobi, as we know in Trinidad, another concentrated sugar syrup. It is added to the water. The process of osmosis begins. Osmosis is a chemical process where two solutions, one concentrated and one dilute, are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. The molecules from the concentrated begin, the exchange movement begins from one to the other, and in that, to attain to the same level of concentration. Now in that, the water and that concentrated solution has attained to same level of concentration or consistency. The concentrated sugar syrup is not as sweet as it was, because it has lent its sweetness to the water. Water that was tasteless has become sweet now. The two have dissolved into one another. This can be one way to understand Fana. You are making, but how it happens? You want to make tea. There are various ingredients that are required. You require tea leaf, you require sugar, you require milk, you require water. But if you put all these things together, they will not become tea. Unless the water is hot enough to absorb the qualities of all the ingredients. So it is put on the fire. Fire becomes the catalyst. It does nothing, but in its presence, everything, the sugar, the milk, the water, the tea leaf, pearl of these lends its quality, tea leaf lends its quality, sugar lends its quality, milk lends its quality, and in a proper proportion. When these are mixed, we obtain tea. So heat is love. Love creates an intense state where the seeker is in extreme, intense love with the master that creates a heat. Slowly and slowly all the diverse faculties into him dissolve into that and attain to a state. Persons having entered this state are said to have no existence outside of and unity with Allah. Fanna is equivalent to certain concepts that exist in Buddhism as Nirvana or Moksha in Hinduism, which also means annihilation. The highest state of Fanna is reached when you are not even aware of the concept of Fanna. In the beginning, the two, the water and tea leaf, were separate. But when they dissolve in the two, they lose their identity. Tea leaf is no more tea leaf, water is no more water. This is here in case of man. I am trying to attain to state of Fanna. Then slowly and slowly all the faculties dissolve, passing away, and then you even forget that you have attained to Fanna. And this happens through a various stages which in Sufi terminology is known as mukamat. And with each mukamat there comes a subjective experience which is known as ahval. This practice of absorption continues until annihilation of the self. Self means what? I had explained earlier, you have sense organs, eyes, ears, nose, throat, skin, through which you experience the outer world of objects and beings. You are listening to me through your ears, I am speaking through the vocal cord, and so many things. And when everything begins to dissolve, and this happens through maraqaba, the eyes are seeing something, an image is formed, ears are listening to something, a sound is formed, sound attains a form, the touch. All these things put their information into a space. Then there is a faculty, the space that is created within, that you become aware, that is maraqaba, meditation, that coordinates the activities of all these. So integrated information comes out of that. When this begins to happen constantly with you, with the seeker, it is known as he has become Insanul Kamil, or the perfect man. It is the integration of man's narrow self-concept that I am the mind, I am the ego sense. And then when we talk about ego sense or nafs, there are different types, seven types of nafs. which has been explained earlier on. The narrow self, the concept of self, the social self, the limited intellect, it is like a drop has merged into the ocean. This is one way. The moment tea leaf dissolves into the water, it lends its quality. And this is a state, makam. When all the individual units have dissolved into the oneness, this stage is also known as Fanna fit Tawheed, extinction with unity, and Fanna fil Haq, extinction with reality. You have experienced Haq for the first time, that you have known your reality. Your reality is the emptiness that you have attained through the state of Maraqa, a state of meditation. You are neither the body, nor mind, nor intellect. You are neither identified with any of these. But as an individual, you are identified with all these things. You are, some are identified with ego, then you are identified with your intellect, and so on and so forth. When this happens, your journey towards the ultimate reality or inward journey begins. This journey is known as Safare Uruzi. Uruz means to rise. When the water begins to evaporate, vapors begin to go up. All that was unwanted, water attains to its purity and becomes vapors. This state is known as Safre Uruzi. This is ascendance. Then there is a descendance also. Then comes the term known as Fanna Filla, extinction of the self in God. One of the important phases or the mukamat in mystical experience, which is attained by the grace of God, by the seeker along the path, and this state is known as Fanna fi Allah. But before that, many stages comes. Fanna fi ul Shaykh. When the disciple is so much lost into the Shaykh that he understands the very words of the Master. Master does not have to say anything. The saliks or the disciples' inner self becomes a mirror to reflect all that happens on the Master. Master does not have to say anything, but the seeker comes to know that. At this stage of inner development, the salik is said to have attained the state of Fanna fi ul Shaykh. He is lost in his Shaykh. He has no other thought but that of his Shaykh. Completely, so in a way, he disappears, the Shaykh remains. As far as the consciousness is concerned, but the physical existence, the separation still remains. It is important to mention that this is not a state of incarnation or union. Most Sufis, while passing through this experience, have preferred to live in the greatest depth of silence, which transcends all forms and sounds, and enjoy their union with their beloved. Then, along this journey, another state comes. When you are so much lost into your this shake, that shake cannot remain without your thoughts. You love your beloved so much. Your love is sharing. That has created a state within that of your spouse. The love begins to respond. The spouse also thinks of you every finite moment. When shake begins to think in about a seeker, that particular state is known as Fanna fi ul murid. It is very easy to attain to a state of Fanna fi ul shaykh, but a rare seeker attains to the state of Fanna fi ul murid. Hazrat Maulana Fazl Ahmad Khan Razi Allah Ta'ala Anhu, who was the 37th Sheikh in the Naqshbandi Mujaddadi Majhariya Tariqat, he said about Lalaji that you have not only attained to the state of Fanna fi ul Sheikh, but you have attained the state of Fanna fi ul Murid as well. When this state of complete annihilation of different aspects of the self attains to absorption or intoxication in God, the pilgrim is unable to participate in worldly affairs. He reaches to another state that is known as Fana al-Fana, forgetfulness of even annihilation, forgetfulness even of Fana. At this stage, he becomes a mazoom. He is so much lost, and such a person becomes not of much benefit to the other, to the seeker. It is a sort of oblivion or a state of unconsciousness. Since two negative make one positive, the seeker at this stage remains his individuality as he was when he started his journey. The only difference is that in the beginning he was self-conscious, but after having reposed in the divine being, he regains a different sort of individuality, which is God consciousness or absorption in God. This state is known as Baka bi Allah, living or subsistence by God. This is also known as Sair min Allah. You are journeying through that realm. When this happens, Baka bi Allah, when that state is attained, the descendants of the downward journey of the seeker begins. You have attained, Allah has, or the consciousness or awareness has attained its totality. Now what master says to his Khalifa, now you are ready to share what I have given it to you. This state is known as Safre Nuzuli, the downward journey, descendance. He comes to the world and continues to do the work of transformation of human consciousness. No one can subsist with Supreme Creator, and to believe as such is shirk. What really happens that the persons of that the seeker's awareness of Allah increases so much that he forgets his own self and is totally lost in is attains to that unity, the dissolution happens in the magnificence. Baka bi Allah. This is the state where man comes back to the existence, that is where the Safre Nuzuli begins, and God appoints him to guide the seekers that come in his company. This state is one in which individual is part of the world, but unconcerned about his or her rewards or positions in it. And he says that there is nothing for me to attain in this three universe. When you have attained to that state of bliss, what else do I have to attain? When I am subsisting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He takes care of all my needs, then I do not need anything. I am not worried about my actions. I do as guided by my consciousness. If consciousness permits me, allows me to do this, because it is all ilham, the direction that is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His inner self, the ego, is dissolved completely. He is not living with the memory. He is not living with all that is finite and changeable. That he comes out. He is in the world, but the world is not in him. He continues to live in the world. He looks like one of you, but he is something more than that. And this state is explained in Quran-e-Pak, Quran-e-Majeed, in one of the verses. When Sufi come out of this state of Fana fi Allah state and enter Baka bi Allah, many of them have produced works of unsurpassed glory, especially in the field of philosophy, literature and music. Hazrat Amir Khusro Raziyallahu Ta'ala Anhu, Hazrat Hafiz Shirazi, these works have crowned the culture of the entire Islamic world and inspired Sufis and non-Sufis for generations. The great Persian poet Hafiz Shirazi, who is remembered as the voice of the unseen, unknown and unknowable, he said, whose heart is alive with love never dies. Allah says about these people in Quran-e-Pak, Quran-e-Majeed again, lo, indeed the friends of God have no fear, nor are they grieved. But the seeker has asked a question. Isn't it before attaining to this state, fana fi nafs is necessary? Fana means dissolution, when you dissolve and become one with shape. From that point of view, theoretically, fana fi nafs seems right. The seeker seems to be right, saying that before that state I must attain the state of fana fi nafs. But fana means dissolution. When you dissolve, the tea leaf dissolves in the water, it does not remain tea leaf. It comes in a different state. When the river water dissolves into the ocean, it is no more identified as the river water or the drop of the river. Instead, it is identified as the drop from the ocean, and ocean lends its quality. When, as you say, that you have to attain to Fanna fuel nafs, that means you are dissolving into nafs. You are attaining to the quality of nafs. The process of dissolving nafs is totally different. Understanding, because nafs is a reflection, the false reflection. It is like a mirage. When there is an intense heat, sun is at its peak, and in the desert there is sand. And when the sunlight falls on the sand, it gives an impression that there is water. This is a mirage. So, nafs is that state. When the light falls, it creates an impression or reflections, and we consider it as our own reality. But this is not the real. It has to dissolve, and the process of dissolution of nafs is a totally different thing. You have to understand that first of all, it is a reflection of the reality, not the reality. But if reality is there, the reflection is bound to be there. So first of all, you have to understand that there is something like reality or haq. When we see, we have to live by the reality or haq, not by its reflection. And just that understanding, the process of the dissolution of nafs begins. So it is erroneous to say that we can introduce a term as Fanna fuel nafs. It is not right. Had it been so, the sheikhs would have introduced this word. The process of the dissolution of nafs is totally different. And I have already spoken on this, but once again from another angle, in the coming session I will speak on that. But then the seeker has also mentioned of a saying from Hadith, which is very important. فَمَنْ عَرْفَ نَفْسَهُ مَنْ عَرْفَ نَفْسَهُ One who has known himself, because you are identified with nafs. You have to understand first the mind, the man, and then the nafs. Fa man arfa nafsahu, fa kad arfa rabbahu. One who has known the reality of the mind and the nafs is capable of knowing the Rabb. Rabb means the one who is the master of the entire universe. You can call it, if you call it by Allah, immediately a form comes to your mind. If you call it Bhagwan, a form comes to your mind. If you say awareness or consciousness or light or noor, no form can come to your mind. Can you give a form to noor? Can you give a form to awareness? Can you give a form to consciousness? But in the beginning you can do, for it is acceptable. But in the final analysis, you cannot. When maturity comes, all forms dissolve. There remains just oneness. The light has no form. It is known only by its manifestations. Awareness is known by its manifestations. Consciousness is manifested, is known by its manifestations. You cannot see it. You cannot feel it. But when it comes in the form of beauty, you can feel it. When it comes in the form of love, you can feel it, but you cannot see it. That is why three other doors, Hak, Satyam, that which is eternal, unborn, unmanifest, light is always there, awareness is always there. You are not aware of it. God is always there, but we are not aware of it. Three doors, Hak, the experience that I am beyond birth and death, born out of self-illumined. No one gives me the birth. The birth is given to the body. Body dies, whether it is of a Hindu, Muslim or Christian or Jew or Buddhist. But that which is within, the Noor, the awareness, that light is unborn, beyond death and birth. And then you experience the beauty. Through the door of beauty, you can also reach there. It captivates your heart. It sends you into a totally a different dimension of dissolution. So we cannot say that Fanna fuel nafs, man arfa nafsahu faqad arfa rabbahu, is an important statement of the hadith. Once you have known your mind, its reality, and you have understood that nafs is the reflection, if you want to show the sun, little children want to catch the sun or the moon, you take a platter, a deep platter full of water and put it. Its reflection will be there. But that reflection is simply reflecting the moon, but it is not moon. Nafs begin to reflect the reality, but it is mixed up with many other things. If the reflection of the moon falls wherever there is a reflecting surface, if the surface of the water is not clean, the reflection will be unclean. If the water is not still, it is wavering, the reflection will continue to waver. This is the state of nafs. It continues to waver. When the water in the pond is muddy, the reflection will be muddy. If there are many waves, the reflection will continue to flicker and it will not be as stable. When the water becomes still, calm, no disturbance from within is there, then the reflection becomes still, and that time the nafs dissolves. I will speak on this aspect